हेलो, वेलकम टू द टुडेज लेक्चर ऑन ट्रेवलिंग वेब ट्यूब्स। तो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव वाचिंग द माइक्रोवेव ट्यूब्स। इन दिस रिगार्ड वी हैव रेड अबाउट द टू कैविटी क्लेस्ट्रॉन एम्पलीफायर एंड रिफ्लेक्स क्लेस्ट्रॉन ऑसिलेटर। ओके, सो फर्दर इन दिस लेक्चर विल स्टडी अबाउट द ट्रेवलिंग वेव ट्यूब्स। ओके, सो दिस इज अ स्लो वेव स्ट्रक्चर एंड स्लो वेव स्ट्रक्चर्स मे बी ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स। सो दिस इज अ हेलिकल लाइन। Okay, this is traveling wave tube. So, and the electromagnetic waves or RF signal will pass through this. Okay, this one, and its diameter is d. Its diameter is d. Okay. So, what will be the relationship between D and P? Okay, so the total length of one turn, total length of one turn is, let us suppose here is given one turn. So it will be the combination of this one, this circle plus this piece. Okay, so if we open this circle, then it will be pi d. It will be pi d. Okay. And this will be length. Okay, so this is shown here in this figure. Okay, so this is P, this is pitch, and this is pi d. Pi d is nothing but the circumference of the circle. So this is a right angle triangle. So if this is pi d and this is P, this hypotenuse will be under root pi d whole square plus p square. Pi d whole square plus p square. Okay. So length. As we know, if the wave is traveling, wave is propagating through this line, so actual traveling is this one. Actual traveling of wave is this one, this one. Okay, pi d whole square plus p square under root. But the net displacement is, wave will start from here and it will travel like this, 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 travel like this. The whole one turn means this length it will travel. Okay, and the pitch which is being traveled is P. Okay, so the wave is traveled in this axial direction is P. The wave is traveling in this axial direction is only P distance. Okay, but the actual distance the wave is covered is pi d whole square plus P square. So we can say that the wave is traveling in this helix with velocity c, but the wave is traveling in this direction, axial direction, with phase velocity v. Okay, so we can again say that the wave is traveling in this direction. Okay, the whole length is given by this one. So pi d is whole square plus p square under root. The wave is traveling in this direction with velocity c, and wave in this direction. Okay, in this direction is traveling with velocity vp, phase velocity. Okay. So this is vp. It is traveling with velocity vp in this direction p, and with velocity c it is traveling in this direction. So let us suppose it will be proportional. Okay, so vp will be proportional to p, will be proportional to vp, and this pi d whole square plus p square under root will be directly proportional to c. So we can write this one, vp upon c means v upon this one, and this is nothing but sin. So what will be the v? P. So take this c in this side and take p square common from here, and it will cancel through it. Okay, now folded. So there are so many other also slow wave structures. This one is the folded back line. Okay, so this is folded back line, and this is zigzag line. Okay, and this is corrugated wave type. Okay, so wave is traveling in this direction or along this wire with velocity v, but the phase velocity or the wave traveling in this direction will be lesser than this, and likewise the wave traveling in this direction along the wire, it will travel with velocity c, but in this direction it will travel with the smaller velocity, let us say vp. Okay, so now this is the concept of slow wave structure. Now here we will see the traveling wave tube amplifier. This is again amplifier, so it will be like two cavity klystron amplifier. So we provide the larger path to travel to EM wave as compared to electron beam, which travels in a straight line. As I mentioned to you that this RF input is traveling a larger distance. Okay, because it is traveling round and round, round and round, round and round, but the net displacement in this axial direction is very slow. Okay, so this EM wave is traveling with lesser speed or velocity in this direction. Okay, so first of all, we will watch the construction. So it is made up of electron gun. It is made up of electron gun. So what is electron gun? This filament, okay, this heater, this filament, this cathode, this control anode. Okay, so accelerating and coaxing anode, all these things are your electron gun. And second thing is RF interaction circuit. So what is RF interaction circuit? So all these things, okay, this RF input, okay, so these things is RF interaction, in which RF input is traveling round and round around this helix, and the electron beam is coming with the constant velocity at this till this point. Okay, after that there will be some velocity modulation, and what will happen we'll see. But from here to here, that is shown in by the red color, it is nothing but the RF interaction circuit. Now coming to the next thing, that is electron beam focusing magnet. Electron beam focusing magnet. So what is electron beam focusing magnet? This one. This is the magnet. Okay. The upper part and the lower part. This is magnet, focusing magnet. So what will it do? Okay, it will hold the electrons, hold the electron beam to travel in a concentrated manner, or in a beam, or in a narrow beam in pencil. So what it will do, yeah, or why the electron beams are spreading? Okay, so it is this electron beam focusing magnet. Okay, stop spreading of this electron. So because all the electrons having the same charge, that is negative charge. So negative charge. Will the repulsor. Okay, so they try to go spread. Okay, that will force or feel a repulsive force, that's why it want to spread. So to keep these electrons in the narrow beam, we use this electron focusing magnet, electron beam focusing magnet. And the another thing is this one, attenuator. So what is attenuator? This one is the attenuator. What is the purpose of attenuator? Attenuator attenuates the any type of signal that is coming back after reflection. Okay, it will attenuate this signal. Okay, so this signal will not be allowed to pass in this direction. Okay, so if a small amount of signal will be reflected back, and it will be suppressed due to this attenuator. So after attenuator, it will be very very small, and that will not be significant. Okay, so these are the things. And last one is the collector. So this is the collector. After all the operation has been completed, this collector collect all the electrons of the electron beam. Okay, so let us see what happens. And collector is at negative potential. Collector will be at positive potential, because it will have to attract the electron. Okay, and there is a positive supply that has been supplied to this magnet also. So let us watch the working. What is the working of this TWP amplifier? Okay, so first of all, heater starts, and it starts heating the filament. So it will eject the electron. Okay, it will eject the electron. By the help of this cathode and control anode, these electrons will be focused and accelerated. These electrons will be accelerated and focused. So it will convert into a smaller beam. So it produces an electron beam. So overall, these things is known as the electron beam, okay, or electron gun. Electron gun supplies the electron beam, and because of the potential, negative potential here, positive potential here, these electrons will also get accelerated, and all the electrons will reach up to this point with a constant. Okay. After reaching here, okay, so all the electrons which are entering this point in the retarded field, okay, negative cycle, they will be deaccelerated, and which will enter into this cycle, into positive half cycle. Okay, so the electron which is entering this circuit in positive half cycle will be accelerated, and the electrons which are entering here in the negative half cycle, that will be deaccelerated. Okay, and the electron which are entering this point in the when the RF input voltage is zero, so that will travel with the same velocity. Okay, that velocity will not be changed. So concept is similar. If an early electron which is accelerated, deaccelerated, and the late electron which is accelerated, so what happened? They will combine together. They will combine together. Okay, and let us suppose here it starts bunching, okay, and here the bunch is complete. Okay, bunching process is completed here. So what happens? That if this bunch is passing this loop, okay, or this turn, when the RF input is in the retarding phase, then this electron beam will provide the whole energy to this RF input. Okay, so again this will be accelerated because focusing magnet is there, so none of the electron is going to spread. Okay, so again bunching will start. Okay, let us suppose again next bunching has completed here. Okay, and again it is in the retarded phase, and if the electron beam is reaching at any position where field is being retarded, so this electron bunch will provide most of its energy to this retarding phase input, okay, or signal, retarding phase signal, or you can say that maximum power transfer will take place. Okay, so that is very simple. So we can see all these things in graph. Okay, so here it is, a graph. Okay, we are watching that RF input, okay, has entered here okay, and started bunching, and bunch is completed here. Okay, bunching is completed at this phase. So this is the retarding phase. So this bunch will give the energy to this RF field. Okay, again, so this is some this is amplified now. Now it is again coming to this zero, and at this point this again bunching is there. So these bunched electrons will again provide the energy to it, and it will again amplify. But we are seeing that after certain time, two or three cycles, it has amplified, and then it is its amplitude has decreased drastically, and then it has amplified to a very high value. Why? Because the electron which is coming from this side to this side, okay, this RF input is amplified up to this point, up to which the attenuator is not there. Okay, so this RF input is a small signal here. Okay, it will amplify it here, it will amplify it here, but since this is attenuator, and at what is the work of attenuator? It will attenuate the reflected signal. But it, since its property is of attenuation, so it will attenuate both, either the wave is coming from this side or either the wave is coming from this side, so it will attenuate. Okay, so the wave which has very small amplitude has now amplified, has now more amplified, and now it will start de-amplifying, and now it is again amplifying, this is again amplifying, this is again amplifying, this is again amplifying. So this is the process. Okay, so due to this attenuator, the forward signal which was being amplified is now attenuated from here to here. This is the effect of attenuator. So you can think that if such amplified signal is attenuated to this level, then what will happen to the signal that is coming back? That is a very weak signal which is getting reflected and one. Okay, so this signal will be very weak signal, and if it will go pass through this attenuator, its amplitude will be very very less. Okay, and that will be not significant, you can say. So if its amplitude is like this, it is not significant. Okay, so this is the reason. So attenuator is taken, because if attenuator will not be there, the reflected power may damage this electron. Okay, so this is the reason, and these are the steps you can follow. Okay, electrons are emitted from the filament, focused by the cathode, focused and accelerated by the control anode. Okay, and gain velocity V naught. Electron enters into the helix with a constant velocity. All these things we have covered. Okay. So all these things we have covered. Okay. So I think you must have understood the working of it. So let's see the specification. Frequency range is 1 to 100 gigahertz. power output up to 10 kilowatt, okay, power gain up to 60 watt, and efficiency from 20 to 40%. So what is the application of TWT? So it is an amplifier. It is a low noise RF amplifier in a broadband microwave receiver. So it is very important because it is a LNA, low noise amplifier. Okay. Repeater amplifier in wide band communication link and long distance telephone. So it is high power amplifier and it is a wide band amplifier. So it is more, it has a larger and broader application. Okay. So due to long tube life, TWT is power output tube in the communication satellite. Because its life is too long. So TWT power amplifier is used in the communication satellite also. So that is in the space. For medium power and higher power satellite transponder output, it is also integrated in the transponder. And because its life is long, it is a wideband amplifier, so it has, and it is a low noise amplifier. This is the reason that is why it is. And power gain is up to 60 dB. 60 dB means 10 to the power 6. So 1 lakh times it will amplify. Used in airborne and seaborne pulse high power radars, electronic countermeasure system, military applications, phased array radar. So these are the some applications of this one. I think you must have understood. Okay. So you can go through all these things. These are the points. The electrons entering into the helix when RF field is accelerating. They are accelerated, I told you. The electrons entering into the helix when RF is negative. They are deaccelerated, I told you. The electrons which enters the helix when RF field is zero, velocity remains same, I told you. Hence, bunch are formed, I told you. Okay. Velocity of the electrons reaching the helix are adjusted so that the bunch is formed in the next cycle of the RF field in the retarding phase. This is very, very important line. I am saying from beginning that the bunch should be such that it should be in the next retarding phase. Okay. So as shown in the figure, it will be bunched in after every cycle. Okay. So that it can transfer their energy to the RF. Okay, so it is transferring their energy many times. Okay, cycle and cycle. So due to AC content in the bunch and its interaction with the RF field in the retarding phase, the maximum power is transferred to the RF field from the electron beam. The amplification of RF wave takes. Okay. So all these things are same, which I have told you. Okay. So I hope you must have understood the concept of traveling wave tube amplifier. Okay. So it is a high power amplifier and low noise amplifier. Okay. And it uses the concept of velocity modulation and current modulation, okay, and by the concept that if the electron bunch, okay, is interacted with the retarding phase of the RF input, okay, this electron bunch which has high energy, that will transfer their energy to the RF field. Okay, so thus the signal is okay. Thank you for the watching, and still you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe so that you can get the latest videos, okay, from my channel. Okay, thank you.